Hi children, in our last section we discussed about distance time graph and different kinds of distance time graph and the uses of distance time graph. Today we are going to discuss about velocity time graph. Today we are discussing about velocity time graph. In distance time graph, you know that distance is along y-axis and time is along x-axis. Here also, listen here. Here this is the velocity time graph I am going to plot. Here, this is time is along x-axis and velocity is along y-axis, and velocity is in meter per second and time is in second. Okay. So, to plot a graph, we have to take an example. So, let us consider this is an example of a motion, a small example of a motion. Okay. Here, the time interval and velocity is given. Time in second and velocity in meter per second is given. Okay. So, the time interval is after 2 minutes, the object travels with a speed of or velocity of 10 meter per second, and after 4 second it is 20 meter per second, after 6 second it is 30 meter per second, and after 8 second it is 40 meter per second. Okay, then let us mark the points in the graph. Here we know that time is along x-axis. So, we can take the scale on x-axis, 1 centimeter is equal to 2 second. So, 2 second, 4 second, 6 second, 8 second, and the corresponding y value, that is on y axis, 1 centimeter is equal to 10 meter per second. So 20 meter per second, and then 30 meter per second, and then here it is 40 meter per second. Okay, then we can mark the points. Okay, so after 2 second the object travels with a speed of 10 meter per second. Then after 4 seconds, the object travels a speed of 20 meter per second. Then after 6 seconds, the object travels with a speed of 30 meter per second and so on. Okay, after 8 it is 40 meter per second. So, I am going to join this line. Okay. If I join this line, I will get a straight line. So, what can we understand? From this data you listen. The time interval you can notice. 2 plus 2, 4. 4 plus 2, 6. 6 plus 2, 8. So, equal time intervals. And the change in velocity. 10, 20, 30, 40. So, for each time interval, the object increases its speed or velocity 10 meter per second. So, we studied that if an object travels if an object changes its velocity in equal intervals of time, then that motion is said to be uniformly accelerated motion. So, here this is an example of uniformly accelerated motion. So, you can see for all uniformly accelerated motion, the graph is a straight line with slope. Okay. So, from this graph, we can find the acceleration and also we can find the distance traveled by the object. Okay. So, for that purpose, let us consider 2 points on the graph. At any instant of its motion, consider 2 points. Let it A and this is B. A and B are the two points on the graph. Okay, so first we are going to see the acceleration of this motion. So how can we calculate acceleration from this graph? So I just marked or I just considered two points A and B on the graph. Then I draw a line parallel to x-axis from the point A and it is extended like this. I draw a parallel line through the point A and another parallel line to a line parallel to y-axis from the point B also. Okay. So this is another line which is parallel to B. So what I did, I draw a line parallel to x-axis from the point A and another line parallel to y-axis from the point B. And these two lines meet at the point C. Okay. This is the meeting point or point of intersection. Okay. So from this graph, how can we find the acceleration? Here, acceleration is equal to the slope of the graph. Okay. So acceleration A is equal to, we can write like this, BC by AC. Okay. Here, what is BC? Here, what is BC? How can we calculate this length? Okay, that is 20 and 30. So we can find out BC, the line BC. A is equal to 20, that is 30 minus 20. Okay, then what is AC? AC is the time interval. AC means this is the time interval. So what time interval here? 6 minus 4. That is 6 minus 4. So acceleration A is equal to 10 by 2, which is equal to 5 meter per second square. Okay, so in this way we can find the acceleration of an object from the graph. This is one of the use of the velocity time graph. That is, by using velocity time graph we can find the acceleration of an object. Okay, then once again I will repeat. Consider two points A and B on the graph and draw a parallel line from the point A and draw another parallel line parallel to y-axis from the point B, and these two lines meet at the point C. Then after we can find out the slope of the graph. Acceleration is equal to the slope of the graph, that is acceleration A is equal to BC, that is velocity divided by AC, time. So velocity by time is equal to acceleration, and acceleration BC 30 minus 20 and AC is equal to 6 minus 4. So acceleration of the object is equal to 10 by 2. And this acceleration is a constant at any instant of the motion. This acceleration is constant. So this motion is said to be uniformly accelerated motion. Okay. Next, we can check how can we find the distance traveled from this graph. Next, we are going to see how can we find the distance traveled from this graph. Okay. So, to find the distance traveled from this graph, listen here. Distance traveled can be given by area under the graph. Okay, so let us consider here the same two points. And the distance traveled is equal to the area under the graph. When we consider these two points, the area under the graph means this is the area under the graph. Okay. So we have to find the distance traveled, or S is equal to area under the graph. So we can give the name for this point also. Here A, B, C, and this is D, and this is E. So area under the graph means the distance traveled by the object during this time interval is given by area of the shape AB, CD, E. Okay, so this is area of AB, CD, E. Okay, so you can see this figure. It consists of a triangle and a rectangle. So area of this figure we can split and write, that is area of the rectangle ABC plus, that is area of rectangle. rectangle ABC plus area of triangle ABC plus area of rectangle ACDE. ACDE. Okay, that is area of triangle ABC plus area of rectangle ACDE. Okay, that is the distance traveled. Distance means magnitude of displacement. We can consider it is magnitude of displacement. So, S is equal to, what is the area of this triangle? Area of the triangle, we know that half BH. So, here we can write it as half into half BH. This AC into BC plus, what is the area of a rectangle? Length into breadth. So, plus what we can write here? AC into or here it is AE into ED. AE into ED. Okay. ED. ED. AE into ED. So, then we can substitute values. That is S is equal to half into what is AC here? AC means what is this time interval? So, what is AC? AC is equal to 6 minus 4. What is 6 minus 4? AC is equal to 2 into what is BC? AC into BC. What is BC here? BC means the velocity, that is 10. So, BC 10 plus what is this? AE is equal to what is AE is equal to 20 meter per second. AE is equal to 20 meter per second and what is ED is equal to 2. So here 20 into 2. So what we will get it as the distance traveled by the object during this time interval is equal to 2 cancels each other. Then 20 into 2 means 40. 40 plus 10 means 50. Okay, so the distance traveled by the object is equal to 50 meter. In this way, we can calculate the distance traveled by the object from the velocity time graph. Okay, then next we can see velocity time graph for uniform motion or uniform speed. Velocity time graph for uniform speed. If speed is a constant, how can we represent through a graph? So here also the same way we can plot the graph like this. That is, here it is velocity in meter per second and time in second. So, we can mark the time interval 1, 2, 3, 4. And here it is on y-axis I took it as 1 centimeter is equal to 5 meter. So, then 10, again 15, again 20. Okay. So, 20 meter per second. For a, what we can write, if an object is moving with a constant speed, how can we plot the graph? Listen here, let the object is moving with a speed of 20 meter per second. After one minute or 1 second, what is its speed? What is the speed of an object is equal to 20? Okay, again after 2 seconds, what is the speed? Again 20. Then after 3 seconds, what is the speed? Again 20. After the 4 seconds, again what is the speed of an object is 20. So what does it mean? The objects moving with a constant velocity. The velocity not increase or decrease with respect to time. That is, the object is moving with a constant velocity. So when we joined all these points, we will get a straight line parallel to x-axis. So what we can say from this graph? The velocity time graph for an object is moving with constant velocity is a straight line parallel to x-axis. If the Velocity time graph is a straight line parallel to x-axis, which means the object moves with a constant velocity. That is, the speed velocity is not changing for all the time interval. After any second, what is that? The speed velocity is equal to 20 meter per second. So, this is the velocity time graph for constant speed or velocity. From here, how can we find the distance traveled by the object? So, we learned that the area under the graph, in a velocity time graph, the area under the graph gives the distance traveled by the object. Here also, let us consider two points A and B. Okay, then I mark the corresponding time interval here. Okay, here I marked the corresponding time interval, and this is this point I mark it as say B, and this is A, B, C and D. Okay, so how can we find that is the distance traveled by the object is equal to the area under the graph. So how can we find this? Just look the shape of the graph. Shape. What is the shape of this shape? Is a rectangle. Okay, so if you find the area of this rectangle, so this is the distance traveled. S is equal to distance traveled and area under the graph. This is the area. So area of the S is equal to area of rectangle ABCD. So S area of the rectangle is equal to what we can write it as AB into BC. So what is AB? What is AB? AB is the time interval. So, what is the time interval here? That is 4 minus 1. Time interval AB is equal to 4 minus 1. So, this is the time interval. So, initial and final time is given. So, we can minus to get the time interval 4 minus 1. So, 3 into what is BC here? BC means it is the velocity. What is the velocity here? BC is equal to 20 meter per second. So, what can we write here? Distance traveled by the object is equal to 3 into 20. That is equal to 60. 60 meter is the distance traveled by the object. So, this is another one use of velocity time graph. Okay. So, by using this is the graph of an object moving with a constant speed or velocity. Next, velocity. Next, velocity time graph for non-uniform motion. Velocity time graph for non-uniform acceleration. In the case of a non-uniform acceleration, what is the shape of velocity time graph? So again, we can plot the graph like this. You know that time in second, and here it is velocity in meter per second. Okay, and mark the points same way 1, 2, 3, 4 or 2, 4, 6, any. So here I am using 1, this is 2. And this is 3 and it is 4. And the time interval or the distance traveled by the object is, I taken it as 10, 20, 30, 40. Okay. Then we can, so let us consider this, how this object is moving. Okay. So here there is a small data to draw the graph. How can we plot the graph? You listen. So this is time and this is velocity meter per second. Time is in second. So after 1 second, the object moving with a speed of 20 meter per second. Again, it is 10 meter per second. And after 3 seconds, it is again 30. Okay, then it is again come back to that is 40. Okay. So, this is the, so from this you can understand the equal intervals of time. What is the change in velocity. So let us mark the points. After 1 second, the object travels at with a speed of 20. So this is 20. After 2 seconds, it is 10. And after 3 seconds, it is 30. And after 4 seconds, it is 40. Maybe 5 is there, means any value we can write it as 25 or any value. So again like this. So what happened from this graph? The object is moving from the rest. Okay, this is the origin. So when we plot the graph like this, the graph can see. Okay. So what can we understand from here? For uniform acceleration, the graph can have any shape. Okay. For a uniformly, for non-uniform acceleration, the graph can any shape. For that means because the velocity increase and decreases, it is not equal in equal intervals of time. So in non-uniform accelerated motion, the velocity time graph can have any shape. Okay. So today we discussed about velocity time graph for uniform acceleration. In the case of a uniform acceleration, the velocity time graph is a straight line with slope. And from this graph, we can find the acceleration and also distance traveled. The next point is the velocity time graph for constant velocity. So, the graph is a straight line parallel to x-axis. Next, the velocity time graph for non-uniform acceleration. For non-uniform accelerated motion, the velocity time graph can have any shape. Okay. So, let us revise the topic once again. Today we discussed about velocity time graph. It is a graph obtained by plotting velocity of the body along y-axis and time is along x-axis. Velocity time graph for uniform acceleration, velocity time graph for non-uniform acceleration, and velocity time graph for constant velocity. Velocity time graph for uniform acceleration. Here we plot the graph between velocity and time. Time is along x-axis and velocity is along y-axis. And for all uniformly accelerated motion, the graph is a straight line with slope. From this graph, we can find the acceleration. So, the slope of the graph gives acceleration. Here, small letter A represents acceleration and A is equal to BC by AC. Here, BC means the velocity and AC is the time interval. So, A is equal to velocity by time. Then we can find out the distance traveled by the object or magnitude of displacement. The area under the graph gives the magnitude of displacement or the distance traveled. So here S is equal to area of the figure A, B, C, D, E, which is equal to area of ABC plus area of ACD. So, we know that the area of a triangle is equal to half BH and area of rectangle is length into breadth. So, here S is equal to half into AC into BC plus AE into ED. So, in this way, we can find out the distance traveled from velocity time graph for uniform acceleration. Next, velocity time graph for uniform velocity. Velocity time graph for uniform velocity is a straight line parallel to x-axis.
velocity time graph for non-uniform acceleration. Velocity time graph for non-uniform acceleration can have any shape because the object is not moving with a constant speed. The velocity of the object changes many times. Uses of velocity time graph. The uses of velocity time graph as follows. To determine the speed of a body at any instant. To determine the acceleration of a body. To determine the total distance traveled by a body in a given time interval. Worksheet. Question number 1. What is velocity time graph of a body? Draw velocity time graph for A body moving with uniform velocity. B. A body moving with uniform acceleration. C. A body moving with non-uniform acceleration. Second question. List the uses of velocity time graph. Third question. How can you calculate acceleration and distance traveled or magnitude of displacement by an object from velocity time graph? So complete the notes, and if you have any doubts, you can send your doubts through WhatsApp, and after completing today's note, if possible, you can send the notes through WhatsApp. Thank you. Have a good day.